G'day. I don't know where I am or where I'm going. I just felt like getting out, and so I chose this forest. I saw there's a river section kind of running through it. I'm just gonna kind of see if I can find the river. Some water would be nice. Set up some shelter because I'm getting pretty wet. It was supposed to be sunny today and 26 degrees. I was gonna try and find this big waterfall and camp at it and swim in it, but I don't really want to do that in 10 degree rain. Anyway, I'm not gonna get anywhere if I keep standing here and talking, so let's be on our way. I can hear some water. It's not a massive river, but it's something. This is very bushy. Okay. All right, my feet are now at the edge of the river. Oh, creek. It's very pretty. There's all these little leafy greens growing on top of the surface of the water. I think this will make for a rather nice little campsite. This area is quite flat just here, and then I've got very close access to the river behind me. I'll run you through my swag setup in a little bit. I'm just gonna get some lunch into me, and then we can go through all of that. Oh my God, I've got another one on me. Little bastard, piss off. So this green satchel here is what I store all of my food in, or anything that I need urgent access to along the trail. It's an old Austrian army satchel, and then yeah, inside I've got like a tarp so I can quickly get up a shelter if I need, and most importantly my lunch. It's nice to have a sit down. I know not meant to put sauce on a sandwich until you start eating it. I was like, whatever, it'll be fine. The barbecue sauce has been absorbed so greatly into the bread roll that there is no barbecue sauce on any of the ingredients in the middle. It's literally just a barbecued bun. Anyway, enough yapping and more eating. Oh, I just had the most foul thing happen. So, cause this is quite a wet sandwich, there's a lot of like sloppy crumbs going onto my fingers, like tomato and bits of soggy bread and whatever. I felt a wet bit go on my finger. And so I bit it like to try and lick it up, and it wouldn't crunch. And I had bitten a leech. I bit into this bloody leech and then it got caught in my mouth and I had to spit it out. Ugh. As soon as it got into my mouth, I was terrified it was gonna like cling to my gum or something. But I think my bite kind of sent it into a panic as well, because it wasn't clinging onto anything. I don't know if you can see, but My knife has quite a nice pommel at the end of it, quite flat. So it's good for pegging things in when you don't have an axe. It's crazy how much light can make a difference to a place, because before this felt like a, you know, very gloomy, kind of creepy, very isolating forest. But now with a bit of sun coming through the trees, it feels quite magical and inviting. God, there's three leeches on the top. I'm gonna get eaten alive tonight. Let's do one last adjustment to the truckers hitch to make sure it's as tight as possible. Oh God. I just realized I have tied this to a totally dead tree. I could knock this over right now if I wanted to, but I won't because it's holding up my tarp. Oh shit. All right, I'll show you how the swag works now. So swags are a traditional bedroll that Australians would use throughout the 1800s, probably early 1900s. It's a large canvas roll, which is waterproof, and you put all of your bedding inside of the sack. And it's not only your bedroll, but it is also your backpack. So as I'll show you now, when you roll this out, you've got all of your belongings inside. So what I've got at the end of the swag here is a pillow, my stove. I've got some shorts, swimming shorts in case, you know, it got really hot and I could swim. My pots, and then inside my pots I've got ferro rod, sugar, herbs, spices, sponges, you know, anything you need cooking related. And then in this pouch here I've got all my other crap, which is just, you know, toilet paper, trowel, fire bellow, life straw, you know, all kinds of crap. So what I like about taking a swag is you really, really have to think about what equipment you're going to bring, because it has to be able to fit and roll up into the roll. And it means you end up cutting out a lot of the unnecessary items that we usually bring for comfort, and it really cuts things back to the basics. You can of course still pack quite a few things into that satchel, which you sling over your shoulder, but even then I keep that pretty light. So this model of swag, I haven't used a lot, but when I have used it, it's been really, really fun and really, really durable. I'm pretty sure they're called Saul of Tawonga or Saul Swags, S-A-U-L. So I'll link them down in the description if you want to check it out. They do a lot of other kind of traditional Australian tools, which is really cool. So when you're packing the swag, this is the head end where you put all your equipment. So you put it at the sides like so, and then you fold that in and roll from here. And by folding it in at the sides, it means none of the gear will slip out the sides of the roll. And the thing I probably love the most about a traditional swag is that my bed is already made inside. I've got my sleeping mattress and I've got my sleeping bag, and I've just got to chuck my pillow there and I'm done. So one other thing I'll just show you quickly is how this swag actually opens up. It's called an envelope swag because there are two folds that come in to form the bed and protect you like a blanket. And so when you open it up like this, you can then use this area as a ground sheet, which is really, really nice. You don't want to get it too dirty because you're going to be, you know, rolling it back on top of yourself at night. Starting to rain very, very lightly, and so I think I'm going to get into the A-frame. I was thinking about getting out the stove and making some noodles, but I don't really want to do that in the rain. Oh my God, so many leeches. Oh, there's leeches on my bed. Get off my bed. God, they're all on the walls too.
I'm gonna go for a little walk downstream, see if the valley opens up at all and whether more water collects the further down we go, see if there's some like pools or something. Far out, check out this. So peaceful. And the river continues off this way, up into this flat area. This would have been such a better campsite. Oh, you can totally climb in there. Let's see.
I don't really want to go in there.
There's so many spider webs.
Oh, fuck. Yeah, no. I don't mess with spiders.
I'll give you a little look up the trunk. I doubt you'll see anything.
Anything interesting?
Yeah, no, I didn't think so. These trees here are a different species. I don't know anything about trees. I don't know what they're called, but they're different. That's all I can say. Different to everything else. So it's kind of making this kind of cozy, low canopy amidst this larger forest. Jeez. I know I keep saying it, but this whole area is just so clear and flat. It's just infinite camping spot opportunities. I don't know how far I want to go. this is going to go on forever. If I recall correctly, this does fall off onto a huge waterfall. That's like probably a good 30 kilometers, which I'm not going to be doing right now. I think I've seen all that is interesting. So now I'm going to walk back to camp for an hour. You get to skip that. Yeah. I did bring this little Fresnel lens on the off chance I could use the sun, but that sure is not happening.
I wish I had some veggies for this, but this really was a last minute trip, so I just whacked together the easiest food I could find.
Apparently everyone finds it very annoying that I do this, but I leave the water in with my noodles because then you get a soupy treat at the end because the flavor sachet goes through all the water and you can drink it up and it's like a nice tea or something. And why would you waste the water? I also ate my noodles with a spoon because then every mouthful you get some of that delicious flavorsome water. I'm starving, so this is going to do absolutely nothing for me other than give me some flavor. Since I've moved out into the countryside, I've found that all of the forests that I go to, they're very wide and open like this, and they're very accessible. Where I used to explore and go on adventures, there was just head-high shrub, impenetrable vines. It was just a nightmare trying to get anywhere. But since coming out here, I've found these trips to be a lot easier going, walking-wise. So weird, every time I go camping, there's this one point throughout the trip and it's when I just get this massive endorphin release. And it just kind of hit then when everything was getting dark and my eyes were drawn to all the orange of the crumbling fire. Such a nice moment, and it usually only happens once on the trip. I think it's probably because the first half of the trip you're still unwinding from your regular life and adapting to everything, and it's usually around the campfire at night that you finally sort of re-acclimatize to the natural world, and any bullshit going on in your life just kind of slips away. Thank you.
go. I wish I had some traditional, you know, damper to cook up, or even a steak would be nice, but again, rushed trips don't come with nice food. So I'm going to be eating lamb fettuccine. I don't know how to pronounce it. Well, its powdery form smells nice, so. That steam burnt my hand. All right, and now for the painful 10-minute wait. All right, moment of truth. Well, it looks very boring. Oh, are you serious? It's raining. Like, properly raining. Literally the second I'm about to take my first bite around the campfire. Oh, please go away. That actually tastes really, really good. I'm gonna get inside the tarp, I suppose. Now I finally get to eat. I just have to drag everything inside.
It is now 8, the rain has not stopped, so I've just been trapped in here, drifting off to sleep every now and then. Anyway, I won't be getting out and doing anything else for the night, so I'll just call it here and see you in the morning. Unfortunately, it has continued raining today. I've just been waiting for a break in the rain, which there finally is one. Time to get out of the swag and get wet, I suppose. Goodbye.